Hey everybody, it's Brian from iSpring, and today we're going to compare iSpring Cloud Sharing Service and iSpring Learn LMS so you can choose the best way to host your content online. iSpring Learn is an LMS designed for online education and business training, where you have a class of students or employees log into your LMS portal for training. You can create and host courses, deliver them to users, issue certificates, get reports, and check completion details. Also, you can sell your courses online and automate user registration. It's in the same category as Moodle or any other LMS. iSpring Cloud is for business and marketing purposes, where you upload PowerPoint presentations and share them online with your clients, prospects, or partners. Viewing doesn't require a login and is therefore good for vast audiences. You can get general statistics on views, but can't teach people online. I guess you could compare iSpring Cloud with a service like SlideShare or Dropbox, but it's actually way cooler than either of those. First, I'm going to show you some of the cool features of iSpring Cloud. Let's start by uploading a PowerPoint presentation. Just click Upload, then choose your PPT file, and it'll be automatically converted to online format. This is great for Mac users or anyone else who only wants to share basic PowerPoints without all the extra e-learning features offered by iSpring Suite. Now let me show you the different sharing options. You can copy this link or post it on social media, send it via email, or even embed it on your website or blog with an embed code. There are even some content protection options to secure your content from unauthorized viewing, sharing, and downloading. iSpring Cloud also comes with some fairly basic tracking capabilities, which I cover in another tutorial, but in brief, you can track views on your content, as well as email campaigns. And that about covers it for iSpring Cloud, because the people management is virtually the same as in iSpring Learn. Okay, now here we are in iSpring Learn LMS, and I'm going to take a moment to show you the more advanced capabilities for e-learning. Let's go right here to the reporting section and see what I'm talking about. As you can see, there are far more extensive reports than iSpring Cloud, which let you view statistics on your learner's performance from a broad perspective, or even an answer-by-answer breakdown. Another thing that differentiates iSpring Learn from iSpring Cloud is the e-commerce option, which lets you sell courses and view the sales figures here. Now let's hop over here to the content section and see what else iSpring Learn has to offer. You can add any rich media file or full e-learning course, but you can also put a bunch of content together in a learning path that must be completed step by step, plus add a web link for further study, or create a freeform assignment that requires personal approval by a teacher who is registered in the system. Now let's go down here and click on a content item to see how easy it is to share. Unlike iSpring Cloud, you aren't sending materials to just anyone. In most cases, these will be learners who are already registered in the LMS, so normally you'll be choosing an organization and one or more individual groups or users to share this content with. Otherwise, you can still enter a list of email addresses to invite new users to view the content and get registered in the LMS. And that brings us to the people section. Keep in mind that you can organize users here much the same as in iSpring Cloud, but instead of marketers and salespeople, you're mostly dealing with teachers and trainers on the one hand, and students and trainees on the other. You can organize all users into convenient groups and organizations for quick and easy management and assignment, and you can even instantly collect information right from the sign-in process with the user profile fields. Adding users and organizing them is super fast and easy, and can be done in this little window here, or in a spreadsheet with this import option right here. Users can be assigned different roles: administrator, organization administrator, publisher, and student. Another important feature of any LMS is communication between learners and instructors, and that can be handled right here in the discussions section, or in the comments section on any content item. Plus, there's an awesome feature in iSpring Learn which is a staple of any electronic learning experience, and that's webinars. It's extremely easy to create, host, and manage webinars right here in the LMS, and track analytics on participants and the questions they asked. Finally, no LMS would be complete without gamification. You can enable gamification features right here in the settings, and find out more about how this feature works by following this link. Well, that about covers it for this comparison of iSpring Learn and iSpring Cloud. If you want to learn more about either solution, I highly recommend you check out the rich repository of tutorials on YouTube, Vimeo, or the iSpring website to find out exactly what you're looking for. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.